Hello there. This background you're seeing right now was made almost entirely without drawing. I used a system or method or technique perhaps that I haven't seen been used by other artists at all, but that I think it's really powerful, especially for those artists who are not 100% confident in their drawing skill. And I'm not gonna keep you waiting. Let me tell you right away what this system is all about. Basically, it's about building your own library of generic, reusable assets that you can use to quickly put together a sketch. And from there, you follow a series of steps until you get to the finalized piece. In this video, I will go through each of these steps, going in detail on how you can build your own cartoon background using an asset pack and without drawing. What's more, I'm gonna give you the exact same pack I'm using here for you to immediately put into practice what this video shows you. The free download link is in the description. Quick warning, I'm gonna be using the free vector software Inkscape to draw this background. You do not need to use Inkscape or a vector software to use this method, but it just works better with a software that can easily handle assets like objects. Okay, let's begin. The very first step is building a decently sized asset pack. So I guess you do have to draw after all. But it's always much easier to draw something in isolation than in a composition. Of course, I will be very happy if you just download the one I left for you. Believe it or not, that one is actually more than enough for most type of landscapes. However, sooner or later you'll want to add your own assets to better match the style you're going for, or the subject, or maybe you'll just want more options. Okay, so how do you make them? Especially if you're a beginner who's not completely comfortable drawing. You steal them. Well, not really. What I do is to find cartoons similar in style to what I'm going for, and then search for assets that look generic and reusable enough. Obviously, don't trace or copy those assets. What you have to do is to make a different version. For example, I really like these creepy trees in the background. I would like to have one of those in my pack, but instead of making a copy of any one in particular, I'll just make a new one that feels like it could fit in there with the other ones. You can choose any cartoon you like to do this, but this method works best with those with a simpler style. Simple assets work better together and are easier to draw. I tend to gravitate to the style used in the 90s and early 2000s cartoons like Dexter's Laboratory, Fairly OddParents, Danny Phantom. Those shows look amazing and their backgrounds are super simple. One last thing, you don't need a big asset pack at all. You'd be surprised to see with how few assets you can build a fully dressed background. Instead, what you want is for each asset to be fairly generic and reusable. The more generic it is, the more flexibility you have and the less amount of assets you'll need. So keep that in mind. The next step is essential, the planning phase. It is very tempting, now that you have a pack of nice and finished assets, to try to put something nice together right away. But believe me, you should never skip this step. Everyone and their mother will tell you, it's never a good idea to delve straight into a final illustration. Instead, you first plan everything out with a quick sketch. And this tip still holds true when you're working with an asset pack. This step is nothing more than just making a quick sketch, there's nothing else to it. However, I can give you a few tips that will help you make better sketches that will result in better compositions. So here are my three essential tips to make thumbnails. First, always think and define a single idea or concept you would like to explore. Write it down if necessary. Perhaps something like a mysterious shadow in the forest, or a serene mountain view lake, or an aggressive and inhospitable forest. Having a clearly defined idea will guide you through the sketching phase and let you iterate over it with much more lucidity. Second, always base your sketches on reference. Gather pictures, real life pictures, that matches your idea more or less and make a rough version of it. Maybe mix and match with other pictures that are similar. That way you inform yourself better, which will always result in better quality compositions. And finally, this one is very important. Make at least 5 to 10 variations on the exact same idea or concept. Your first sketch will probably not be your best, and because these sketches are meant to be made quick and rough, it should be no problem to do a lot of them in a few minutes, so you can choose your favorite out of the bunch. Most of the time you want to go for hand-drawn thumbnails, but in this example I decided to make a thumbnail sketch directly in Inkscape using the assets themselves. It is 100% valid and possible to use the asset pack to sketch out something, but as long as you keep in mind that this is just a rough idea and that you're meant to refine it later on. And now it's time to actually start with the final illustration. Here basically we are doing a new version of the sketch, but this time placing the assets with more care and making everything look as good as possible. So let me give you the three most important rules at the time of placing the assets. First, distribute objects naturally. It is very intuitive to place objects in equal spaces like a grid, but in nature, this does not happen. Be attentive to this grid and avoid equal separation between objects. Second, overlap as much as possible. In this type of cartoon landscape, you don't often follow perspective, so the best way to imply depthness is by overlapping. Make sure most assets are overlapping, at least partially, with one another. And the final tip, avoid tangents. A tangent is when the border of two assets touch, and this results in some uncomfortable tension that you don't want most of the time. So always be on the lookout for any kind of tangents and break them off by overlapping or moving away the asset. This step of placing the final assets is the single most important step of them all. Everything else you can sort of wing it, but here, your knowledge of composition really matters. If you're interested in learning more, not just about composition, but also about making cartoon backgrounds with this method of using assets and not drawing, everything in this tutorial is taken from my full course, The Easiest Method for Cartoon Backgrounds, where I go through all of these steps with much more depth and detail. I'll let you know that you can get it bundled with other cartoon backgrounds course, as well as an Inkscape course. That will get you making cartoon backgrounds in no time, even as a complete beginner. It's also at a special price, link in the description below. Purchasing those courses is the single best way you can help support the channel right now. Anyway, continuing with the next step, color. In my opinion, the easiest way to give it color is to use the ancient artist technique of stealing. This is a very common thing to do, however. Search for references that matches the mood, time of day, and theme. You want it to have more or less similar style to the one you're working on. In this particular case, I'm going for this amazing background made by artist Chris Borges. And now, with the reference in hand, it's just a matter of start swapping the colors with the ones in there. The color of the sky with the color of the reference's sky, the trees with the trees, the grass with the grass. And if you don't find an object that matches with the objects in your composition, find something that approximates or just looks good. Eventually you'll get a nice base to build upon. And that's the thing, you'll get a base. Not everything will fit 100% of the time. You'll need to make minor adjustments. Let me tell you about a really easy way to do this. When a color is not working for you, go to the HSL color selection mode and start moving the S and L slider just a bit. Not too much. You want to stay close to the original color. See if that makes it better, and if it doesn't, start also messing with the H slider. If you fiddle enough with these sliders, eventually you'll find a color that works great. And with the colors in place, you can move on to the next step, or if you want, now it's much easier to add more things to further dress the illustration with assets. Okay, I guess we could leave it like this. It looks pretty good already. But if you want to go the extra mile, the final step will be to add light and shadow. It's not that difficult to do, and it makes a background look 10 times better in my opinion. So here is how I like to do that in Inkscape. I just add highlight shapes and shadow shapes right on top. Usually that's enough to imply illumination. The key is to imagine a light position and aligning both types of shapes to that. It's easier than it looks, besides you don't need to be that accurate. Not all objects should have a highlight shape, only those who have a section of their surface being hit directly by the light source, but keep in mind that most objects should have a shadow shape. There's a couple of really easy tricks to always give the correct colors. For the highlight shape, give it the color of the surface so they are the same, and then go to the HSL mode and move the L slider slightly to the right until it feels like it's an area in light. For the shadow, you could do the same, but opposite, moving the L slider to the left. But I like to go for a technique that's fairly well known. Give it a low opacity dark color like black or dark blue, and then go to the HSL mode and move the A slider left until the shape feels like it's a transparent shadow. One final tip, not all objects need highlights and shadows. In fact, you probably don't want anything on the background layers and sometimes in the middle ground. But that depends on the size of the object and what it's made of. And finally, with the light and shadow done, this is how my final kitbash non-drawn background looks like. But we are not done yet. There is one last step, the most important of them all, liking and subscribing to the channel. I make Inkscape and illustration videos every week, and I do plan to start making more stuff related to background design in the future. Also, comments and feedback are always highly appreciated. Let me know if you prefer I go more in the direction of illustration, or maybe in the direction of just pure Inkscape. I hope you enjoyed the tutorial. That was all for now. Thanks for watching and have fun making backgrounds. Bye!